Mountain lion. Are you down here? I don't know where he is. Sounded like he was in my yard. Oh, he is my yard! Shit! Welcome back, everybody, to 7 Days to Die. I'm the Bearded OG, and in this episode, we're going to do a little bit of work around the house, and then we'll probably go out and do a job. So let's see, a couple of off-camera things to show you. First of all, I bought another beaker from Trader Gin.
My priority.
And we used that beaker to make ourselves another Kim bench to have at the house because I left the one that we have in the underground bunker there. Let's see. We also looted a cop car. On the way back to the old base, I found several dead zombos on the road. I guess their TTL ran out. That's time to live for those of you who aren't network geeks. And there were some bags on the road, so I looted those. Along the way, I also killed a dire wolf. And the next day in the forest on the way back here from the old base, there was a wolf horde, which included another dire wolf. So we dispatched him. Also learned the first aid kit recipe from that. And then finally, I learned the nail gun 5. All right, so as far as stuff around the house, I have moved the workbench into this spot here. There were a couple, there was one closet door. I removed that. As I already mentioned, I set the Kim bench up here, and I have the forge in here with a storage bin for forge materials. This I just put frame blocks in for now. I broke the ladder out, put frame blocks in because it is a way that zombies can get in here. And if one does happen to come this way, then we can just shoot him, through the frame blocks. I might do something different with this more permanently, but that's just, what I have in place for right now. I also, I went back to the forest base and hauled some more stuff over here. Brought more seeds and stuff like that over. And, these four storage bins that you see here, we got so much concrete. Are just temporary. They're not, this isn't necessarily at all where they're going to stay. In fact, what I'm thinking about doing is making this our storage room. We already have some shelves in here. What I might do is actually leave the shelves in place just for, for the visual. And then, just kind of build storage crates. We'll upgrade all of those crates to steel, of course, kind of around the crates. And yeah, this will be our storage room. That's, kind of what's in my head at the moment, but we'll see, what ultimately happens. As far as the kitchen goes, I've done some changes up here too. I put in a temporary cooking pot here, but what we're going to do, and actually what my plan is to do for this episode, is to fix the kitchen up. So fix all the broken cupboards, spawn in whatever we need to if I can't make it outright, you know, like a new dishwasher. And one thing I decided to do, guys, is I installed Jax Teller's working items, I think it's called. Hold on. Working devices. So what this mod basically does is it makes it so you can fix ovens and sinks and grills, that sort of thing, and make them actual working devices. And the way you do that is you have to craft repair kits, right? So there's a repair kit for grills, there's one for sinks, one for stoves, and one for wood stoves. And then they actually function and work. And also this mod adds empty jars back into the game too, because that way you can then take the empty jar and, you know, get the water out of the sink. I looked at that mod, and I have used this mod before too in my Ranger series back in Alpha 20 or 21, whichever Alpha is that I did that series. I also looked at and am considering another mod by the mod author Little Red Sonia that adds actual plumbing into the game and makes sinks and toilets and all that kind of stuff work, and at three different levels. So the first level gives you murky water. The second level gives you clean water, filtered water, and then the third level gives you actual mineral water, but you do have to pay for it. It's not for free. So that's something I'm maybe considering too, but I think we'll start with Jax Teller's mod. By the way, Jax Teller is the author, the main author, as far as I'm aware, of Ravenhearst too, in case you guys don't know who he is. So we'll start with his mod, and then we'll kind of see, you know, how things go from there. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started with, you know, just kind of getting our kitchen cleaned up, starting by, you know, fixing all of the broken cabinets and the stoves. And I don't think we can fix the microwave, but what we can do is we can spawn one in out of the creative menu. That's weird. There must have been something underneath that coffee maker to at least simulate repairing it, even though, you know, it won't be functional. Okay, so let's see. To start this process, I should be able to make in the workbench cabinets for the kitchen. And I think, too, what I'd like to do is I'd like to replace the kind of yucky gray cabinets. Oh, yeah, I made a crucible, too, by the way, as you can see there. Let's put that in here. And this is just kind of, right now I'm just, you know, smelting clay down into it, but I haven't gone mining yet. Well, actually, I did go do some mining at the forest base to fill up the forge there to make some more steel, you know, because we are going to do the next horde night there, which is in 2 nights from now, by the way. So any hoozle, yeah, let's take a look and see. If we go into here and we go to decor, of course, we can make appliances, but I don't think they will function. Well, actually, what if we can make a fridge? Ugly chair. Where's cabinets? Sectional, metal furniture, office chair, mailbox. I don't even see cabinets in here. Coolers. Can we not make cabinets? Got to be able to make cabinets. Maybe it's something we do from here. Let's take a look. Okay, let's go here. Deco. Okay, so it looks like we can maybe make cabinets. What if I just try and filter that? Cabinet ajar or cabinet broken door. Is it called cupboard instead? Ah, okay. Cupboard ajar, cupboard corner. But I don't want cupboard ajar. I want an actual working cupboard. So we might have to spawn that in from the creative menu. I'm just looking here. What's that? Oh, that's one of those mortician drawer thingies. Okay. Okay, well, I'll tell you what then. What we'll do is we'll... It, If I make a cabinet a jar, well, that's only going to cost me one wood thingy, right? Let's look in here again for just a minute. Oh, here we go. Cabinets and covers. That's what I was looking for. Okay. So, yeah. We just need nails and then a bunch of wood. I was pretty sure we could make that. I just wasn't looking in the right place. I got 7 nails in there. None of this stuff is organized. It's all just kind of all over the place right at the moment because it's not its permanent place. Okay, we're going to have to make some nails. How many can we make? 4? Shit. Okay. That sucks. I guess I'm going to have to go mine up some iron. God damn it. Well, we can make 2 cabinets. Yeah, I'm going to have to go mine up some iron. Well, let's at least, like I said, we'll do the 2. And we should be able to change the style and all that, right? Yeah, okay. Cabinet filler, no loot. Cupboard. Where's the nice, like, redwood? Oh, is this it? Okay, here. Let's not put it down here. Okay, so we'll start with this one. I think that's what I want. We're probably gonna have to paint these though. Yeah, because this is the shitty looking cabinet. Cabinet filler, no loot. Okay. Yeah, so I don't know, that doesn't seem to look as good as it used to. But it does function. Maybe we need to paint it. Okay, let's run back down here. I haven't actually messed around with painting or decor in 1.0. What do we need to make a paintbrush? Just some wood and hide. All right, so let's make the paintbrush. And then, do I have any paint or dye? I do back at the old base, but doesn't look like I have any here. Okay, so to make, what do we need to make paint? Do we do that in here? Yes. Oh, just chrysanthemum and water? Okay. Let's go grab some water. And I have a bunch of chrysanthemum and goldenrod. I just picked it while I was in the forest. However, I am planning on planting that. In fact, speaking of which, I have put in crop plots in these 2 spots and these 2 spots, as well as over here. I'm hoping I can repaint these back to a concrete look. But my plan is to, you know, where all these like flower beds and stuff are all along through here, I'm just going to put farm plots in there and then we'll plant crops. But I'm also probably going to plant a large garden, I don't know, maybe out there in that flat area. We'll probably tear down this lift here. Mostly to grow a whole bunch of supercorn. Okay, so anyways, what are we doing? We need water. We got lots of water here. And I've just been keeping it all in here. Yeah, let's just do 1 for now because I'm not going to do any extensive painting at the moment. I just want to test it and see what our options are. Oh, right. We need the chrysanthemum. Just have to remember where I put that. Ah, shit. You know what? I think that's upstairs again. Well, I'm getting my cardio in for today, I suppose. Yeah, I forgot to put that up here because I was going to use it to make mineral water. Did I put it in here? Yeah, here it is. Okay. So let's grab that and What do I need for mineral water? Water, coal, goldenrod, and chrysanthemum. Okay. Why don't we make a batch of that? Which means I gotta go back down here to get coal again. Definitely getting my steps and cardio in today. If only it were happening in real life. Okay, let's just make one thingy of paint. And that'll give us 500 paint. And then we'll take that back upstairs with us and we'll get a batch of mineral water going. Okay, 10 of those. It's going to take 12 and a quarter minutes. Now, let's grab the plate, the paintbrush, and we'll go into here. Materials. Cabinet drawers, cabinet doors. Drawers, doors. Redwood. So these, I think they made these colors duller than they used to be. Because that's what that is, right? Can we do this and at least make that? Okay, so we can change that back to the black marble, which I like. I wish that was kind of the redwood. So the only thing, I don't mind the design of this, but it's just got this, you know, grungy stain shit all over the bottom of it. I also think what we'll do here is we'll texture pick that. And let's make the entire kitchen floor this nice looking black marble tile instead of this grungy other gross tile. Okay. So yeah, I guess we're stuck with this kind of yucko brown color instead of the red, the nice looking red stuff. Because I'm not really seeing any other options here other than the even worse looking crap there. That's just gonna, yeah, that's just gonna paint it and make it look like that. I mean, color-wise, it matches okay, right, with the kitchen, but it just don't like the grungy, stained look that it has. Not sure what other options we really have here. Because if I choose, you know, one of these other things, then it's not going to have the drawers. It'll still work, right, but it won't have the drawers. Yeah. Okay, well, let's go with this for now, and I think it'll have to do, unless, you know, unless I can find something, you know, in a mod or something that we could use instead. So we'll paint all the ones that are in good shape that we don't have to break out, and then the rest of these we will have to. I wonder if I can make that sink look better. We'll have to break. Now, I don't know if we can do dishwashers, but let's go back down and make some of those repair kits. I think I have to do that in here, right? If we just make the appliance a headlight, huh? Okay, let's track that. I need 10 forged iron. We need mechanical parts, pipes, lights, electrical. Here's electrical. Yeah, here we go. I'm just missing them with my eyeballs, I guess. I sworn I had some lights too, because I did go out and salvage a few cars. I didn't salvage a bunch of them, but I did a few. But I'm not seeing the damn headlight. There they are. Okay. It's just hard to see, man. All right. Let's make two of these. One to replace the dishwasher and one to replace the refrigerator. Or do I have two refrigerators up there? I don't remember. Let's make three. As far as the repair kits go, it looks like we just make that in our own inventory. So we want a sink repair kit and two stove repair kits, I think. What am I missing? We need more forged iron. Okay. Well, then here, let's not... Oh, what did I even do there? I don't know. Let's make another one of those. Oh, I told it to make three more. I just want one more. That's what I did wrong there. So let's wait for this first one to finish. Oh, we still have another cabinet we can use as well. What do I need to make my level 5 nail gun? Or 80, rather, forged steel. I don't think I have that much forged steel with me here. Yeah, I only have 20. Oh, there's some more forged iron right there. Oh, there's more iron, too. Okay, let's feed that into here. It just finished. All right, we'll come back for those other ones. Yes, there are two refrigerators up here. So the thing on the refrigerators, what we're going to have to do is we're... Oh, shit. I painted the wrong thing. We're going to have to... Let's see, this needs to be a this guy here. Okay. We're gonna have to make sure we don't ever completely empty it, or then it'll turn back into the opened state. Let's repair the stoves. And now we basically use them as if they were a campfire. Really cool. All right, let's repair the sink. And now press E to pick up. Wait, what? No, I don't want to pick it up. I should be able to... all right, let's try something here. If I go to here and I drink one of you, that should give me a jar. It didn't give me a jar. I thought this mod added jars into the game. I don't see jars. That's interesting. Because I need a jar to get water out of this thing. Okay, I'm gonna have to figure that one out. I'm gonna wait for these waters to finish, and then I'll move all of our whatchamacallits tools over to here for the stove. All right, well then let's do this. Let's go ahead and take the first. Well, let's just take them both out, and then we should be able to. Here and do a refrigerator. Looking to see what else we have in here. Computers. There's the dishwasher right there. New coffee maker. We'll make that too. Okay, so like I said, if we open this up, we got to make sure we always keep something in here, because if we don't enclose it, then it goes to an open state and it's no longer usable. Irritating as hell, but it's the way that it works. Why don't we move all of... Well, here. We'll just move all of this stuff into here. And we'll do another fridge too, so we have both of them. I'll probably... also create a beverage cabinet, you know, like the ones that you can find the Mega Crush and that sort of thing in, and put it somewhere here. We might put, where would we put that? We could put it in place of one of the cupboards. Yeah, we'll have to figure that one out. Let's go ahead and salvage that. Wonder if we can turn that stove into a functional stove. Probably could. I'll bet you we can, actually. Okay, so let's see. We're going to need to... If I break that, will that sink drop? No. Okay. Let's just go ahead and break all of these right now. Probably get a little bit more... Oh! Oh, cool. Picking that up actually repaired it. That's right. I remember reading about that in the mod. Okay. So we just need to make, you know, more cabinets to fill this back in. Oh, shit. Okay. I should have broken, not broken that, but I should have wrenched it. If I wrench this, does it give me a... No, it doesn't give me a working sink. That's interesting. Okay. Let's break that out. And I think that breaks out all of our broken items in here, and we just have to replace them with good ones and then, you know, repaint them. Let's go downstairs and see how we're doing on our other stuff. You, well, shit, no, I don't want to make 500 nails. Let's make 100. Put that stuff in there. Okay, we got a couple more appliances. Let's go back upstairs and put those in place. So this will just be another refrigerator. And then we're going to need a cabinet in place before we can put the whatchamacallit back down. You know what? We don't really need to put that stove back here. Okay, let's grab those two things. If I break this, does that... Yep, that does destroy it. Okay, I'm glad I waited. Because I think we would have lost our cooking pot and grill had we done that. Not that that was would be a huge deal, but... Okay, we'll just make another cooking pot and grill for the bottom one. And yeah, we don't really need to replace those other ones. That other, you know, tabletop stove. Probably just put normal cabinets in there. And, okay, so... Oh, no, yeah, right, it was the dishwasher, wasn't it? So let's get rid of this. And then this we want to go... If we go dish... No, not dick. Dish. I guess we would use this one. Okay, why doesn't it... Oh, there we go. That looks like shit. Same thing, though. We're going to have to keep something in here. So if I figure out, you know, what the deal is on the jars, then we can, like, store empty jars or something in there. Let's go finish making cabinets. I didn't even count how many we need, but we need, what, about 8 to 10, I'm thinking? And cupboards. 20. You know what? Let's actually just make 20 because I'm going to need more for other places in the house. Okay, so let's go ahead and put all of these back in. That needs to be a sink cabinet. This one here. Like so. Now we should be able to put the microwave back in place. And again, we got to keep something in there so it remains usable. This coffee maker is going to go, and I'll make... Oh, that's an under-counter coffee maker. Okay, fair enough. I thought maybe it had been sitting up on something that I broke earlier and was just stuck to the wall. So we'll put actual coffee beans inside of that. I don't know, I still might want to make the larger one, but we'll go with this one for now. Okay, and then let's see, we've got three more cabinets we got to put in place. And then we just have to paint them with the black marble. My game just crashed. What the hell? Like, with no fanfare or anything, just off. All right, I'll be right back. All right, guys, I'm back. Let's try this again. Also, I took a quick look at the mod, and I guess I can only find empty jars in loot. I was under the impression that, you know, we would get an empty jar back after drinking, but apparently that's not the case. So, fair enough. You know, we'll just start looking for them in loot. Be kind of nice if we could also make them in the forge, you know, like we used to be able to do, but apparently that is not the case. All right, I think we have our kitchen all fixed up for now. It also said something about that I needed to upgrade the sink. So, but when I right click on it, it doesn't do anything. So I guess it's... Oh, well, yeah, right. We had to upgrade it with the repair kit. My bad. Okay, so we've already done that. We just need an empty jar to get water from it. So, yeah, I think that's, I wonder if we could get empty water out of here too. I don't know if I want to do that though, because I don't want to break the water block. So we probably won't do that. We'll probably just get it out of the sink. It doesn't look too bad in here. You know, I should probably get some lighting put in too, which I will do. Sounds like we got a horde outside. You sure do. Oh my goodness, that's a lot of yes. Where's my pipe bombs? Say goodnight, Gracie. They're really doing a number on my gate, aren't they? Wow. You know what, though? This might be a good opportunity to just break this gate all the way down and replace it with a working gate. I can do that, right? Let's take a look. Well, no, we'll probably have to go look in the workbench. Those assholes may have done us a favor. Gate. No? Okay, is it door? Iron door. Iron garage door. I don't know what the variations on these would be. iron double door. There's variations. It's probably just different color, I'll bet you. Yeah. We might have to spawn that one in from the creative menu. Decent loot. Okay, how badly damaged is this? It's getting close. All right, let's do this. Let's go into creative. And let's go gate. Roll up security gate. No, we don't want a roll up gate. We want a, that's a chain link. That's a chain link. I don't even see that here. Okay, let's try door. Whoops. There we go. No, that's still chain link. It's, yeah, it's going to be one of these here. White, double, gray. Do we know what color that is? It almost looks like it's maybe a brown. Gray, blue, green, yellow, brown, or white. Here, let's try, let's just look at this real quick to see if it looks like the same color. I think that is actually the right one. Okay, so here's what we're going to do in this situation. I'm going to just, you know, this is a steel gate. So I'm just going to kind of guess how much it would cost for me to craft this. And maybe we could get a close approximation by looking at, you know, what it would cost to craft the... The nice thing about this is now we can open it. You know, we weren't able to open the other one. Oh, shit. What is this? Oh, that's... Yeah, that's weak. Okay, so we need to get that upgraded, too. Let's do this, then. Okay, so to make an equivalent size garage door, so what size is this? Does it tell us? It's a 2x2 door. Okay. Mountain lion. Are you down here? I don't know where he is. Sounded like he was in my yard. Oh, he is my yard. Shit. Dude, what the hell are you doing in my yard? Wow. That's kind of scary. Okay. Someone else banging on my walls? He's not banging on the wall. Somebody else is over here, though. At least I thought I heard somebody banging on the wall. Oh, here he is. I don't think that is the right color gate, but whatever. Guess we can always paint it later if we had to. Okay, anyway, back to this. That mountain lion scared the shit out of me. I mean, it startled me more because I wasn't sure if he was actually in our yard. Okay, so I guess the 3x2 garage door would be the closest equivalent. Except for these are all iron. That gate is a steel. Okay, so let's just do it this way. Let's just do the price of two of these doors because it's a double steel door. Right? And then we'll call that fair. So there's the steel. We just paid for that. And then we need 20 springs and 20 of these. Okay, so we paid for that. And then 20 springs. There. Okay, so we paid for the door. Yeah, so anything I spawn in from the creative menu, I will, I'll follow that MO for quote-unquote paying for it. Now, we could just probably do this, right? No, that doesn't seem to change. Can we just go, like, black? No, it doesn't look like it's paintable. All right, whatever. We'll just leave it the way it is. It's not that big of a deal. It does match, you know, with the concrete. Let's see. We need cobblestone and concrete. Oh, and it looks like scrap iron, too. Oh, shit. I don't think I have any scrap iron now. There's cobble and concrete. We could just scrap these. They're not really worth that much money. If I was desperate for money, that'd be different, but I am not desperate for money, so I'm just looking to see if there's anything else we can scrap that's not a big deal. All right, well, let's just scrap these two things. And hopefully that'll give us enough to get those upgraded. And we actually need to do it across the whole top, but the zombos always come here because this is the weakest point along the wall. There, that should be good. Yeah, we need steel for that. We'll get more of that later. We could actually probably make some right now. Alrighty, good deal. How many of these do I have? I got 12 more. So, if we replace these and that one, I'm just gonna leave these these decorations as they are for now. And then we'll do a copy and rotate, except for this needs to be... it doesn't give us the option of the gray. We're going to have to paint it, and that's fine. Okay, so put those in there. I don't think we have any cabinets in here to replace. All right, let's go with this drawer and that drawer. There. That looks cool. And then, you know, we've got dozens more cabinets throughout the house that we're going to have to replace too, but I'll do that later. We need to get moving if we're going to do a quest, because this has taken me longer than I was expecting to, but that's the story of my life. But I would like to get a job done before I let you guys go, so let's go ahead and do that. And what is our job? It is a fetch and clear at the Helene's residence, which is that way. All right, I'll meet you guys over there in a second. I'm just going to put a few things away. All right, guys, Helene's residence. I have done this POI several times. The brick house. It's a brick boom, 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 house. Okay, sorry. We already know that, Lucky Looter. Put that in there. Okay, so I believe we actually start this in the backyard, and we'll have some dogs to deal with. But I think the dog is... in a shed. Over in the corner there. Got nighttime Zekers with their feral sense on. Hearing us. Take that, Edgar. All right, let's actually get up on the... okay, try that again. Get up on the fence here. The dog's in there. But I guess we have to start the job first. This is a fetch and clear. Oh, there's a mountain lion right there. Shit. He did? Yeah, he did. I think, right? Yeah. Yeah, let's go over here. Whoops. Guess we'll use this. Yeah, there's the head right there. Mountain lions in the desert. That is definitely new on 1.0. I'm pretty sure it is. I don't remember. Pretty sure I played Alpha 21. I think that's what in the version I did my Ranger series on, and I don't remember mountain lions in the desert, but I didn't spend a lot of time in the desert in that playthrough, though, either, so maybe they have been in since Alpha 21. Okay, give me my crossbow. Oh, good. We got both of our crossbow bolts back. We want to definitely be grabbing spoiled meat because we need it for crop plots. So spoiled meat is a high priority item right now. Yes, indeed it is. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else that we need to do down here. Let's go have some fun. Probably going to have a Zeke in the closet there. And a safe, nice. Nobody in there. Probably some Zeke's in there, though. Good, got all of our crossbow bolts back. Spears. And wiring. I don't give a rat's ass about spears, but I do about wiring. So we're going to save that for using with our nerdy chest. That's a pretty decent find if we were in the market for them. Probably will sell for a decent amount if we fix it up, so I think we'll just keep it whole. I'm not going to actually hang on to hop seeds. I've got plenty of those. Armor parts. Can we make... level 5 armor yet? Let's go say like nerdy. Oh, we can. Okay. Yeah, we need to be looking at that too. Couldn't remember if we had gotten to level 5 on that or not. Okay, no bad bads in there. It wants us to go out the window. Don't think there's a bird out here. Let's be ready just in case. Take the pain pills. Probably gonna have some Zikaroos in here. Yes, we are. How about if we give... Is that a normal? Yeah, that's just a normal. You're not supposed to get back up. Okay. Ah, look at that. Huzzah. Nice find. Not as nice as what we have, but still very nice. And 10% more damage to safes. Okay. I really want to get the rest of the urban... The urban... Was it? Urban something or other books. Yeah, urban combat. So that way... Because I have a silencer that I bought, but I don't want to use it until we finish urban combat because of the damage penalty. Plus, all these last... damn near everything in this book series is good. It's really good stuff, but I want to get, all of those will be good too once we get them. All right, anyway, let's continue on here. Dude, fuck off, man. He dropped out of the ceiling too. Nice. Always happy to get a steroid in this game. And it is Mignana. Yeah, look. Jeez, look at the price tag on that. It's not even fixed up. We'll fix it up. I might even put some extra mods on it if I have any. I do, actually. I've got lots of extra mods. Just not sure if I have them here or back at the other base. Okay. Sand is the one thing we do not need to be carrying in our inventory in the desert. Ooh, look at that. I'm in sneak mode, right? Yeah, okay. Nice. I don't remember if there's more Zeeks in this bedroom or not. That's a nice find, too. Wow. Okay, we'll wait to read those till we have our chest piece. Let's go check in here. Let's put this down here. Possible Zeke's in there. Nope. Need feathers. Should we see if there's any wall safes? Nope. All right, up the stairs we go. Yeah, I don't think they're... Forgot about that part. Shit. We messed up our legs, too. Well, it was fortuitous that we found the... Hey, you can't do that. That's cheating. That we found the steroids, right? Dropped him in the basement. That's funny. Ah, shit. Okay, let's take this. I don't actually want to fall down into the basement right at the moment. So let's patch those back up. Save that. Let's go back up into the attic because we have had that one crate up there. Yeah, I forgot about the fall through the floor bullshit. Get that cloth, that plastic. Working stiff. Okay. I don't want that. Okay, I think that's it for up here. Is there something outside this little lattice thingy here? No, there's a pig down there, though. Nope, guess not. Okay. Don't want that. Okay, so yeah, I think we go around this way. There's a book pile. More shotguns, that's good. Tech planet. All right, we need to break outside and go drop a few things off in the bike. Yeah, okay, we'll come back for those. Let me just make sure this next room is clear. Okay, we're gonna have some Zeeks in there, and I think some in there too. Okay. Let's drop off in the bike. Oh, I left the bike out front, didn't I? Shit. Let's go back around this way. Hey, there's some jars. It's a welcome sight. Haven't seen those in this game in a long time. Never should have fucking removed those from the game. It's just one of the stupid ass fun pimps decisions that they sometimes make. I know, it's their game. They can do whatever the fuck they want with it, but that doesn't mean I have to agree with it. I mean, seriously, right? Ah, shit. Okay. What are we not all as likely to loot again? Probably not blueberry seed. Put that in there. Let's wear this. Impact driver quality 6. Okay. That would probably be worth making. Since that's the best salvaging tool we can possibly get. We learned electrician and tier 1 basic electricity. Does that mean we can now... I think that means we can now make a generator. Yes. Very good. Okay. Well, we can make all of that stuff. Because we had to buy the generator that we used at the other base. So that was a nice thing to get. Okay, let's do sledgehammers. Our first steel sledgehammer. Shotguns. And robotics. Robotic sledge quality 3. I have a quality 1 back at the base, but yeah, now we can make a 3. Okay. And put the gasoline in there and the rest of that stuff we got to carry with us. I think we'll leave the Piggly Wiggly alone for now. Possible wall safe? No. Okay, let's grab that stuff. And Oh, and the jar. Yeah, right. Two jars. We just learned, you know, the first aid kit, of course. The big one, so we can make that now. Kind of expensive, but definitely want to make some of those. I got three, you know, from loot, but... Oh. We hit Big Mama with the sledgehammer. Seriously, Big Mama? Cannot believe she didn't know we were there. That's funny. Okay, let's do a quick loot of the kitchen. There's three more jars. Beautiful. Oh, you know what I found out, actually? That coffee maker that we have back at the base? We can actually use it to make coffee. More jars. That's good. So, yeah. We can use it to actually make the coffee straight up, which is really cool. And, of course, makes sense because, you know, coffee maker, right? If I, just out of curiosity, if I wrench this, does it give me a whole fridge? It doesn't. What about that? That doesn't. What about, okay, that didn't. What about this? I think there's a chance. It's not a guaranteed thing, but I think there's a chance of getting appliances. Yeah, see, like I just got that a microwave. And it's power, too, which I think means we can cook directly in it. Or maybe it means I need to power it first. That's probably what it means. We'll hang on to that. Okay. Nope. I don't think washing machines are... Zombo up there. I don't think there's something that we can do anything with. Big Mama. You know, even though we have a very powerful blue compound bow and we're using steel crossbow bullets, remember I only have 1 point in archery, so... you know, considering that, it does pretty damn well. there's a purse up there. Let's just pull up to get that. $7 make you holla. Is that a munitions crate? No, it's just a box. Useful, though. We really want to be checking trash now for the jars. Oh, yeah, we got a mailbox. Tools digest. Switch places with those. Wear and read. We get a bit of a rush of Zeke's in here, don't we? From the ceiling, maybe? Oh, maybe not. Okay. There's a backpack out here, or a duffel bag. Okay, I'm already wearing that, aren't I? Yeah. So that one, I mean, it'd probably be somewhat valuable, but I think I'll just scrap it for the armor part. Okay, let's grab the wood here. Guess that's it. I thought we got a big rush of Zeke's in this room, but apparently we don't. I'm mistaken. Alright, let's just get this thing finished up. Don't think I'm missing anything else from up here. Vehicle book and a handy land. That's nice. Right, might be a Zeke in there. The big group of them's going to be through that door there, though. Shit. Oh, he was in there. I was expecting him to come out of there. All right. We should have a Zombo down here, too, I think. Yeah, he's in there. Guess he doesn't hear us, though. He does now. Look at that. Grandpa's moonshine. Do I already have scrap brass? No. Okay, well, we'll hang on to that then for now. Weapons bake. Okay, this we're just going to scrap for the parts. And that's the first metal chain mod I think I've seen in this playthrough. Not that it does us any good, but we could put it on a club that we find later and sell it. Okay. We're going to have Zom in that closet there. Maybe. Maybe not. Maybe not. Okay. Oh, nice. There's another jar. I wonder if, I wonder if when we use the jars that we find in the wild, if they're consumed. I'm guessing they probably are. Which means, you know, that we obviously can't, I couldn't tell who this is. Is this a normal? I think it is. Fuck you, man. What was I saying? Yeah, it means we can't. Unfortunately, we can't make our own. Okay, now that we have that, we're going to scrap this. No, don't want the hop seed. I got hop seeds, by the way. We will plant beer once we, at some point. That's my plan. All right, if you guys aren't familiar with this POI, all the big bads are in that room right there. There might even be a couple around the other side, but as I recall, there's quite a few of them, and they can be some pretty nasty zombadoos, so we're going to put a hatch down to ensure our survivability. Okay, do I have Molotovs? I do. Okay, let's make sure we have Molotovs and pipe bombs on our inventory. And make sure everybody's loaded, especially you. Jeez, that scared me. I thought that was a zombie head. Ooh. All right. Well, hey, you know what? Say goodnight, Gracie. Dude, die. Now, that's not very strong right there. Oh, yeah, we still have another group over there. And by the way, our satchel is... in here. Okay, got that. Let's get rid of you. I'm keeping goldenrod seed because, you know, we need to grow those for mineral water. Two things of cloth aren't really doing diddly squat for us. And let's go ahead and scrap that pipe bomb. Okay. Let's do this also. Okay. I thought the main group was in that room. I mean, there was a big group in there, but we're not done yet. There's a crawler right there. That all we have to worry about? Yep, that was it. Okay. We were being a little overly cautious there. I'll tell you what, since we have limited space here, let's go empty out into the bike. Okay, well, hopefully we'll have enough room for all the rest of the stuff here. Okay, a couple lockpicks. You know what? I'm not actually going to harvest cement anymore. I've got so much cement, I don't know what to do with it. You know, from our smelting cave, so. Yeah. Ooh, that's kind of a nice find. It's actually a really nice find. All things considered. And shit, we're out of space again. All right, we're going to scrap these. We're going to get rid of those. We're going to drink this. We're going to scrap these. Okay, let's hold on to the plastic for the moment. Two shotgun messiahs. Let's just open this up and see what's in here, and then I'll take care of the rest of this inventory management off camera and meet you guys over at the trader for the turn-in once we see what we got in here. Okay. Hey, Bob.
Don't mind the mess. What can I do? That job was as hard as putting socks on a rooster. Great work.
Yeah, I can imagine putting socks on a rooster would probably be pretty damn hard. Let's see. How about if we take... let's take the pipe bombs. Oh, and we finally finished tier 3. That is amazing. Okay, so we have a shotgun crafting bundle, which will probably give us some mods. But you know what? I think I want the night vision, actually. Yep, we're going to take the night vision mod. Thanks, buddy.
Well, slap my toolbox and call me a mechanic.
I am not going to slap your toolbox. We've already had that conversation. Let's sell all this stuff to him. And I think that's all I want to sell. Those two pieces, like the sniper rifle and the sledgehammer, I want to take back, repair, and put... And this one, too. I'll put some mods on before we sell them. Seems to me like that should be worth a hell of a lot more money. He's got a 4x4 truck chassis. You know, if we bought that from him, well, I still don't think we can assemble it. Or maybe we can. We should look at that. What else you got, brah? Urban combat. We're buying that for sure. He's got a whole mini bike. That's cool. I still haven't found the frickin' reserve tank fuel mod. Okay.
You can't beat that with a stick.
Now, can I assemble a 4x4 if I had the parts? I can. Okay. I think I might have enough bank. I mean, I don't at this moment, but overall, to buy that. He restocks on day 58.
Wouldn't give a duke to see Jesus riding a bicycle.
That's funny. Okay, so we have like 3 days, and I think I already have the money for this. I'm just not sure if I have it all here at the desert or... Well, I probably do, because I don't think I left any money back at the other place. But we should get this, and we should maybe check the other bobs to see if they have the accessories, and then we can just make this, and then we don't even have to worry about...
Well,
I mean, we'll still
like
obviously... You know, we'll still obviously read the magazines, because eventually we're going to want to get the gyro, but at least we could get the 4x sooner than, you know, we'd be ready to in the magazines. I'm not worried about the money, because money's, you know, in the end game, you have money coming out your ears, so it just doesn't matter. Hey, here's some cash for you, dude.
I got vehicles so shiny, they'll blind you in the noonday sun.
In the noonday sun. All right, let's take another job from him.
I knew you were going to buy something.
Opening trade routes.
I should have some work. If you're interested, things are going to be fine as frog fur now.
Okay, we'll do that too. And yeah, let's go back home and see if I have, or do I have any more? Oh shit, zombie. There are still zombies around. Do I have any more cash in here? I don't. All right, I'm going to run back to the base and see if I have enough money. It was 22,000 and change, so let's just say we need 23,000. I think I'm gonna keep the sniper rifle and the assault rifle as backup weapons in case we die. I'm not gonna sell those. But we don't really need a compound bow because we've got, you know, the compound crossbow. And look how much it sells for. So if we put this on here, that increased, well, it didn't increase its price by, see, that's worth 92. And this is worth 2070. That's not super, I mean, it is a little bit of an improvement, but it's not a lot, really. We're only getting another, 30 coin from that? Okay. Well, I don't really need this arrow rest mod, though, because you can't use it on the crossbow anyway, so we'll still do that. All right, now for other mods, we could put this on the spear. So it's currently worth 455. And this is, what is this worth? Okay, 92 once again. No, not that, the spear. Yeah, that doesn't add a whole lot more to it. It's still worth doing as opposed to selling them separately, but I'm a little underwhelmed, to be honest with you, on that. We have a structural brace mod. There, we have two. Okay, so we have two structural brace mods, so let's put one on here. And we're not selling a gun, so none of these gun mods are going to do us any good for that purpose. Fortify and grip mod. I think I want to keep that, because that's the only one I have at the moment. So, you know what? That's good enough. We don't even really need to technically do this. And I think I'm just going to sell that extra microwave too. So we'll put that, and that in there. This. Well, again, that would actually probably be nice to keep as a backup sledge. Yeah, why don't we do that? We'll keep that as a backup. If I was desperate for the money, I wouldn't, but I'm not desperate, so. Okay, let's go sell these items. And Oh, you know what else? We need to make a pumpkin cheesecake, and we need to buy, because this, you know, because this is so damned expensive, we need to buy whatchamacallits? Sugar butts. Which we don't have in our own vending machine. That's disappointing. We'll see if we can find them somewhere else. Man, I hope I have everything here that I need to make pumpkin cheesecake. I might not, now that I think about it. Fuck. I have all that stuff. Okay, we got the beer. And we got the eggs. I've got all that stuff back at the other base. I suppose we don't need to do this right this second. We have 3 days. Just looking to see if I have any pumpkins. I've got pumpkin seed. Oh, we should also be selling these two items. Oh, nuts. Okay. So now I gotta just figure out what's worth our time. I don't know if I can grow a full pumpkin in 3 days' time. Obviously, I could go back to the forest base, but that's a long ways away. Or we could just say fuck it and not use the cream cheese, pumpkin cheesecake. I mean, I would even buy a Grandpa's Awesome Sauce. I think they're 1,500 coin, but this is a big ticket item. All right, well, let's go see if we can find a sugar butt and a Grandpa's Awesome Sauce. And of course, we also have these, which gives us a 4% bartering. We could make the blue version of those, actually. Horser sunglasses. Yeah, hold on. Let's do that. Okay, now we need 5 of those. And I think we have to do the here. Yeah. All right. Let's craft those. 2 seconds. Nice. All right. So let's take the stove out of here and just do a comparison. Okay. So that's a 10%. It was saying that it's 6% better. Plus we have 2 more slots, but that's the only one that really matters for these. Let's just scrap these to get the parts back, because they're not worth that much money. Alright, do you have sugar butts? You don't, you son of a... he doesn't even have the awesome sauce either. Shit. Dude, what the hell?
If you got the dukes, we've got the wheels.
Alright, let's... I'm not willing to do this without... at least an awesome sauce and a candy. I know where there's a vending machine or two. So let me go check those and see if I can find those 2 items. Yeah, here we go. Okay. There's a sugar butts. All right, let's buy that. Now we need to find an awesome sauce. There's one. There we go. Awesome sauce. Okay. Do we have the holding a magnum in your hand gives you 5% better deal? No. That would be this one. Okay.
Don't mind me. I'm just working on my hubcap collection.
We'll take that. We'll take this.
You're looking at the right hombre, partner.
We'll sell you this and this and this and this. All of that. And we got a skill point. Nice. All of those we'll sell to him. Okay. Let's buy the truck chassis. Oh, we brought that down to 14,850. It was 22 something before. That's amazing. Okay, we got ourselves a truck chassis. Now we just need to find, we have 27, almost 28,000 coins still. And I have seen the 4x4 accessories at one of the Bobs. I just don't remember which one it was. And of course, you know, that particular Bob has reset. But you know what I might do is I might go ahead and just visit the Bobs. So we have another Bob. Well, we got lots of Bobs, actually. We have a Bob here. We have a Bob here. And we have a Bob here. We have a fairly high probability of finding the accessories at one of those guys. Because here's the thing. I would love to have the 4x before we finish our move. Because of, you know, obviously, because of all the space that it has. There's a vending machine inside of here, isn't there? Oh, I think I was thinking of this cooler here. Hey, how in the hell did that miss? Since we're here. I think there's something up here, isn't there? Yeah, weapons bag. Should be a dog in here. That's just the garage door, right? Oh, shit! You didn't move, Big Mama! Are you dead now? I turned around and looked at her for, like, well, obviously not long enough. Oh, that's hilarious. Okay. Yeah, I was thinking of this, but that's obviously not a vending machine, so... might as well get some gasoline. All right, guys. Well, we've gotten really long in this episode. I'll probably edit it down a bit. So it's not like crazy long, but what I'm thinking I'm going to do is I think I'm going to travel to all of the Bobs and see if any of them have the accessories. If they don't, then and we also got to go visit Joel to do opening trade routes. If they don't, then I'll work my way back over to the forest base. I need to go back there anyway and get some more steel and pipe bombs going in preparation for Horde Night. And then I might not even start the next episode until the Horde Night, because I mean it's only a day away now. It's day 56. But we'll see. And obviously, if I do find the accessory parts, I will. I'll record that and I'll show you guys that in the next episode. So, with that being said, thanks everybody for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and if you did, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, share out the video, and we'll catch y'all in the next episode. Bye bye.